Hello folks, this is Rodrigo Werle. I'm an extension weed scientist at University of Wisconsin-Madison and also an assistant professor in the Department of Agronomy. Today we're here at Arlington Ag Research and Station, and I'm standing here by my cover crop plots. And I have two main objectives with this video. The first one is to talk about the value of cover crops as part of a weed control program. And the second thing is considerations for a cover crop termination there. Okay. So with the widespread cases of herbicide resistant weeds across the Midwest and beyond, there's been tremendous interest in adopting cover crops as part of a weed management program. The reason being is because cover crops can directly suppress weeds, particularly winter annual weeds. Okay, so your horse weeds, your hembits, field pennycress, dandelions is a perennial plant there as well. So there is a good option here for weed suppression, particularly winter annual weeds. Okay, good stand of a cereal rye once terminated should give good amount of residue in season. And researchers have reported that have found that a good residue of a cover crop there can suppress your summer annual weeds such as your giant ragweed and water hemp. Okay, so cover crops alone are not gonna solve all your weed problems. However, they can be an effective tool in your toolbox or an effective component in your integrated weed management program. Okay, so that's that was the value of cover crops. We're using it as an alternative strategy for weed control, take some of the selection pressure away from our herbicides, okay, or perhaps integrating them with herbicides so you get the best of both worlds. The second aspect I want to visit today here, and we're standing here in the spring, we've just got some rainfall. You look at the forecast, temperatures are looking very promising and warm. So this cover crop that's small now is going to take off in this next week or so. So you better have a good termination plan so this cover crop here does not become your next weed problem. Okay, so farmers can use cover crops multiple ways. Some establish the cover crop for soil protection, some like to see the value of weed suppression that we get, and some see this as an opportunity to feed their animals. Okay, so they'll chop this cereal rye and feed to their herd. Okay, so if you're going to be using this cover crop, a cereal rye cover crop, as a source of feed, the one recommendation there is that you chop it first, okay, and then once you start getting the regrowth, that's when you're going to come and spray your herbicide program, okay? You don't want to do the other way around. We oftentimes get questions from growers, they want to spray and then chop the day after. Don't do that. First you chop, and then you come and you spray the regrowth to terminate that cereal rye cover crop. Okay, now if you're not gonna chop that cereal rye, if you're growing it exclusively from a soil health or soil protection or weed suppression, if that's the reason why you're growing that cover crop, you're gonna need to terminate it prior to your crop establishment. UW researchers recommend that you terminate the cereal rye cover crop 2 weeks prior to establishing your corn and or your soybean crop. Okay, so the main strategies there become either herbicides or a roller crimper. If you go the herbicide route, glyphosate is the most commonly used herbicide used for that purpose. We recommend you spray the herbicide when you have temperatures above 50 degrees so that herbicide can be uptaken and translocated in the plant and will kill it. Okay, usually herbicide programs are going to be more effective to terminate the rye before it heads out. Once it flowers, then it would take more herbicide to terminate it. So usually if you're going herbicides, you want to be terminating that cover crop prior it puts it heads out. Okay, the alternative option to that would be roller crimper. It's increasing popularity there. If you're using a roller crimper, what researchers have shown is that roller crimper becomes more effective after that rye reaches reproductive stages. Okay, so you want to let that rye grow, you want to row it, and then you have a nice mat there to plant on top. Okay, so we terminated our cover crops. The one thing to keep in mind is that if you're struggling with water hemp and some of the other resistant weeds out there, it is of extreme importance that you integrate a pre-emergent herbicide program. Okay, and some of the things to keep in mind is that depending upon how much cover crop residue you have left in that soil surface, that residue may interfere with the fate of the herbicide. Okay, so you want your pre-emergent herbicide to get to the soil and act on the weeds that are going to be emerging. So one thing that you need there considering you have an excessive amount of cover crop residue or even crop leftover crop residue, there is rainfall. So you're going to put that pre-emergence, and you need rainfall so that herbicide gets into the soil and it's activated and it then does its job. Okay, so those are the main things to consider there in terms of the value of cover crops as a weed suppression tool, termination, and integrating with your pre-emergent herbicide programs. Thank you.